Hi everyone, so today's video is a very late what I got for Christmas video, and it's only this late because I kind of needed time to kind of get back into the swing of things before I started filming after Christmas. But I asked on Instagram, on Twitter, if you guys would like to see it, because I really like watching these videos, and a few of you said you wouldn't be interested, but kind of more of you said you would, so I thought I'd do it. And full disclaimer at first, I know this is so boring that we even have to say this, but I'm not showing off, I'm not bragging, this isn't like, look how lucky I am, because I'm fully aware that Christmas in England is very commercial and we're kind of very obsessed with things, and I know that not everybody has that luxury and some people kind of don't even get to spend Christmas with their family, so I'm fully aware of that. I'm fully aware of how lucky and blessed I am, but I kind of can understand why these types of videos can rub people up the wrong way. So with that out of the way, I'm going to jump right in and show you. I'm not going to kind of do who got me what and all that kind of thing, because I always find that a bit pointless, because it's like, I don't know these people. Like, when I'm saying this was from my aunt, and it's like, well, okay, but I don't know who that is, so it doesn't really matter. So I'm going to jump right into it. I've got kind of a selection of different things and I'll talk you through them. This isn't everything as well, because I did get quite a lot of things for kind of house related things. So I got like this beautiful big lantern. It's massive and I can't carry it and show you, so that's kind of been put away already. But the first thing I've got here is this Marilyn Monroe, a collection of beautiful posters, and they're 8 varnished and ready to frame art prints. So it looks like that. Sorry, you can see the kind of lighting from the ring light. And on the back here, it shows you the prints that come in it. So if I kind of show you like that. I have framed 2 of them. I framed that one, and so that one right there, and that one. And oh, you can't see because of the light really, but I love these. I don't know if you know this about me, but I'm a huge, huge Marilyn fan, always have been, and I love kind of photos of her. I just kind of find them, I think they're art, you know, they're not just a picture of a pretty woman, their art to me, because I just think her pictures were so beautiful. So I framed 2 of these. I've got one downstairs, one in the bedroom, and I particularly like the black and white ones, but there are some other really beautiful ones. Let me show you what they look like that one I love. So I just bought some frames and I have framed them, and I thought this was a really lovely gift, so I love that. Then I got this kit from Soap and Glory, and I will tell you who this was from, because my boyfriend, we'd kind of agreed that I had my main present a little bit before Christmas because I wanted a new phone, so we agreed that that was my present, and then he just kind of ignored it and went ahead and bought me loads of other presents, the ring light I'm filming with now being another one of them, so that was kind of naughty. But we saw this in a shop and I said, oh, I like that, I really like the package it comes in, and I thought that it was on offer, and then he obviously went and bought it when I wasn't looking and took it back to the car. I must have like been, I don't know, in another shop or something, and then later he was like, it wasn't on offer, I don't know why I thought it was, and then I got to the till and the woman was like, it's £60. So he foolishly bought this full price, which I think £60 is not, it's not worth it. But it's the Soap and Glory kind of big kit that they do. They do one of these every year. I particularly love the case. I love the lips. I just think it's really, really fun. And I've taken out kind of cardboard, but basically it comes with lots of full products. So it has the Righteous Butter in it, the Scrub of Your Life, Peaches and Clean Cleanser, Heal Genius, Hand Food, this, the Righteous Butter Sun-Kissed Tint Body Lotion, which I haven't tried, and also a shower gel, a mascara, this is the Thick and Fast Mascara, which I've tried, and the Sexy Mother Pucker Lip Gloss as well. So I really like this, and I can't wait to kind of get the products out and start using this case for something. I don't know what I'm going to use it for. I want it somewhere kind of where I can display it, because I think it's so pretty, but not sure where I'm going to put that yet, so I'll just put that over there. Then, moving on to beauty, I suppose, I got this little nail polish kit from Essie, which I love. So you've got 3 polishes in there. This one is called Shearling Darling Parker Perfect and Toggle to the Top. So I love those. I know the lighting's so weird. I'm really, really sorry. I feel like I'm like failing at this lighting situation. I can't get it right. I'm like, the ring light is making everything weird and just, I don't know, I'm not very good at this. And then I got this perfume, and I actually thought that I already had this perfume when I opened it, but then I realised that I've got the different version of it, and it's Juicy Couture's Viva La Juicy, which looks like this. It's really, really lovely. I confused it with Love, Peace and Juicy Couture, but it's a really kind of subtle, slightly warm but still fresh scent. Really, really pretty, and it smells, it's a smell that reminds me of someone, and I can't think who that someone is. Sorry, I keep looking at my hair because I feel like it just looks really weird today. It's clean hair, and you know when it's just too fluffy and not cooperating with you? Whatever, I look horrible today. But I can't think who it is, so that's that one. And then probably the most exciting present that I love is this perfume from Marc Jacobs, and it is Decadence. And I had actually kind of said that I was going to buy this for myself as kind of my Christmas present for me, to me, with some Christmas money that I'd got. But I got this as a gift, and let me just put the lid on for you to give you the full experience, because this is just the most beautiful thing ever. This is what it looks like. Have you ever seen a more beautiful, more decadent perfume bottle? I mean, it is just stunning, and not only is it stunning, it smells amazing. It's very different to the other Marc Jacobs scents, which tend to be kind of a little bit lighter, a little bit fruitier, a little bit more girly. This isn't like that. It's really, really different. It's very warm, and it's warm but without being sweet. It's kind of just a very lovely, warm's the only way I can describe it, fragrance. I haven't got any perfume on, so I'm going to put some on. But God, it just smells amazing, and it lasts for ages as well. It's one of those that you kind of spray on your scarf and you can smell it for days. I think it's made me need to sneeze though. Oh, you know when you like inhale a bit. But yeah, most beautiful thing ever. Don't you want to just like go out with it? Just love it. Even the box is beautiful. The box is like velvet. It's so decadent and fancy. I love it. So that was kind of perfume. Then I... What have I been for? Oh my God. I had a bunch of books that I have now just dropped on the floor. So forgive me for a moment while I pick them up before I show you them. Because what would be the point in that? Okay. Wasn't going to do books first. But after that happened, let's do books. The first one that I got is the Perfume A Century of Scents by Lizzie O'Storm. O'Storm, that's a really cool last name anyway. Looks like this. Beautiful, beautiful book. This ring light situation is driving me insane. Like how? Oh, I don't know. Anyway, basically it's kind of takes you through different years, decades, whatever, through kind of the perfumes that were famous during those decades. So it's even got things in kind of 1920s, 1930s, and then it'll have like 80s perfumes. And it's just really funny kind of when you think about certain perfumes that were of an era. So like the fact that Thierry Mugler's Angel is very much an 80s perfume, and how certain perfumes have dated, certain perfumes haven't. It's a really, really fascinating book if you like perfume, and it's kind of separated into sections. So it'll kind of, you can pick the year that you're the most interested in and the various perfumes. It's a great book. I love it. I haven't kind of read it all yet. I've just read certain sections, but I really, really like it. Then this is the book I'm reading at the moment, and it is just a normal book, not, you know, beauty book. And it's called After Anna. And I'll read you what it says it's about, because it is so good. I only started it like a week ago, and I'm on page 286. I've nearly finished it, really. But it says, a girl is missing, 5 years old, taken from outside her school. She's vanished, traceless. The police are at a loss, her parents beyond grief. Their daughter's lost forever, perhaps dead, perhaps enslaved. But the biggest mystery is yet to come. 1 week after she's abducted, Anna's returned. She has no memory of where she's been, and this, for her mother, is just the beginning of a nightmare. I will... shall I say it? Because it's a spoiler. I won't say it in case some of you want to read it, but I've got a sneaky suspicion who I think it is. So if you've read it, I haven't got to the end yet. If you've read it, then let me know in the comments and I'll tell you who I think it is, and we'll see. But really, really, really enjoying it so far. I kind of look forward to going to bed every night to read it. Then I've got this book here, which is Simply Glamorous, and it's Makeup Transformations to Make You Look and Feel Fabulous by Gary, is it, oh god, I don't know how to pronounce that, Cockerill? I don't know. Cockerill, that can't be right, can it? But yeah, it is just this beautiful coffee table book, and it actually has loads of celebrities in it. I love the beginning part where it has kind of like different faces on it. I think that's so pretty. But it has lots of celebrities in it, so it'll have like, you know, Kelly Brook and that kind of thing. And just a really lovely book. Again, I haven't had a proper look at it yet because most of these things I've kind of been waiting to show in this video, but I really like that. I love makeup books in general. I just love having them, keeping them, looking at them. Which brings me on to this one, which is Face Paint by Lisa Eldridge. Again, lovely book. Some of the images in here are just beautiful. I know this is really weird, but this one's my favourite. I just think it's so gorgeous. Like, I want that hanging on my wall. It's so pretty. Fascinating book. Unlike any other kind of beauty book that's out there, it talks you through kind of the history of makeup in years. So like kind of they'll have like, you know, I want to say prehistoric, not prehistoric, but like Marie Antoinette's years, that kind of thing. Really, really unusual, beautiful book. Like having that out is just something that makes me incredibly happy. And then I will show you just some random little bits that I have got in here that I'm not quite sure, I don't even remember who these were from at this point, but this necklace, I think this was actually from my sister though, and it was from H&M, just a really pretty statement necklace. I've got two picture frames. I know this is really random, I don't know if you even want to see these, but two picture frames, which I haven't put anything in yet, so I will have to find a home for. And then, what is that? Oh, last but not least, this is a really weird thing, but I really like it. This eye mask. Like, I really like this. I think it's really cute, and I'm gonna, next time I fly, take it with me and then sit on a plane like that, and people will think I'm insane, and I will love it. But yeah, that's everything. Sorry this video is kind of all over the place, but I'm all over the place these days. But I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what your favourite Christmas present was, and I hope you all had a fabulous Christmas, and it's only 9 months, like I can't even count. It's only 12 months till Christmas, just saying. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you next time. Bye.